why mostly content agency fail or content marketing fail mostly.
Digital cannot be learned.
Digital is a very application based subject. Without using it, you will not be able to understand how it works.
Yes, content is a damn costly, damn complex, very difficult model. Good morning, brother. My name is Shubhabrata. That's my mascot who looks like me. Before I start, just want to know whom I'm talking to. So just raise hands who are brand owners, marketers. Okay. People are from agency. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. My presentation is quick and sharp and short. I'm the founder and digital chief digital officer for my consulting firm. So we are, how we do and what we do, you will understand. I'm not going to talk about me. I am generally found in 0.45 seconds on Google. Even if you do a wrong spelling mistake, Google will still find me. So you can Google me, who am I? Straight get to the point, I'm going to talk on this. Why mostly content agency fail or content marketing fail? Most. The content marketing or the content process of digital is different from a traditional business. The way we used to do traditional marketing or the way we do content on digital is absolutely different. On digital platform is mostly science. 99% is science and only 1% is credible. 1% is credible. So I see a lot of content people who comes in and boast the self-proclaimed content writer. I hate them, because most of them don't know, understand of content marketing, and you realize when I show you the slides. So let's understand. There's a process for creating content. The first thing which I generally ask most people who don't understand or don't approach is, there's something called persona. Anyone in this room understand persona? Okay. Do you do a persona card? How many cards you do generally when you do a strategy? I'm sure you will learn a lot of stuff here. So persona is the most important tool which you start for before starting a digital content creation. Most people try to search and say, what type of content will I make? Should I make a blog or a video or a text or a slideshare or whatever or a meme? Content don't work like that. This is how a persona card looks like. I'll be shocked if anyone will even know this. Personal card resembles many. Please understand, most people get confused. Target audience research in our old days, what we used to do, is not personality or brand person. This is how a persona look like. Can you see the goal, frustration, motivation and challenges? Based on this four thing, you make actually content. Most companies and agencies start making content about their product. That's not the right approach. Product comes very late on the buying cycle. Most companies start talking about the product advantage, disadvantage, features. That's not the way to make content. It comes at a very later stage. So content marketing starts from the user persona. It starts with frustration and goal. I'll tell you something interesting, you will understand what I'm trying to relate. What I'm trying to tell you is that, imagine a CEO, you're making a product, imagine this product for a CEO, imagine this product costs 20,000 rupees, and you're looking at target audience like CEO, CXOs, you will start making content based on the feature of this product. Your CEO don't care. You should start making content about what CEO care. Imagine his motivation is a solo bike travel in Ladakh. Your content should be that. Imagine his content, he's interested, or his frustration is that he wants to save time. So you should make content about 20 things you should know how to save your time. 20 books you should read to save your time. 20 apps you should use to save your time. That is nothing to do with this product. This product features benefit comes at a very later age of the funnel. So this is how a content, most clients also don't understand. Mostly client drives the agency. Mostly brand managers and marketing heads who are half-baked knowledge and content, they drive agency. No, I want a feature of this. So that is what content is. That's what an agency has no other way but to use and do what the client is saying. And that's the reason most of the content agency don't work, and you end up paying SEO to Google to get you leads. How do my content works? Last 2 years I've built this company. I don't have a single salesman. Z-E-R-O. Zero. I don't have a single salesman. I don't have a proposal letter. I don't pitch. I don't look for clients. Yes. And if you try to go and get in touch with me on my contact me page on my website, it will take you a quiz and it will tell you on the front end, on the masterhead I've mentioned, 97% chance I'll not work with you because you will not understand. In spite of that filter, I get flooded with work. And I actually reject 97% of my people who want to work with me. How do I do that? By the way, I have not paid a single money to ACO. Content is the new SEO. No one tells you this. Content is the new SEO. If you do your content in a rightful manner, you don't need to pay to Google to get traffic, which may or may not buy. And my conversion is 1 minute. So most of the time you go and meet people and you pitch and you meet and you get understand, then you go for negotiation. I don't go for negotiation also. People call me and say, I want to work with you, Shubho. And that's how my conversion ratio is just 1 minute. How can I do that? All of you can do this. No brainer. Great, amazing content, which I'm going to talk here. This is something, content also takes time to build. Content takes, I'll tell you all the math and the science and all the secret sauce I have. I'm going to share everything. So this is how you make content. I have a very deep down blog on this. You may not understand or follow the efficacy, the detail of it. Go to my website and read the entire blog. You will understand how to find a goal, how to get a goal keyword and convert that into a content, and that's how you can attract customers. I also don't see much people understand this word, buyer's journey. Not much people. Everybody try to pay Google to do SEO. There's nothing wrong in it, but that's the only thing they do because they think content marketing is so long, it's so boring, and who's going to pay? You don't get that good writers to do it. Buyer's journey and the different stages, most marketing heads also don't understand this. I'm talking about the CMOs and CXOs that don't understand. So they don't understand or value even a buyer's journey. How does a buyer's journey work? I just went to Pune to one of my clients who called me and said, "Shubho, I want to work with you." He said, my website is ready. So, okay. Who has done the website? X agency has done the website. Okay, the agency has done the website on what basis? Why? It's like they showed us some design and template and we choose. That's not how you make a website. Website is based on the user journey. So where is the user journey? The moment you ask someone, you have done, yes, I've done it. That's okay, show me the document where you have mapped the user journey based on which you make a flow, based on which you actually made a website. Not much people understand or do this. So there is no buyer's journey. So buyer's journey, if you don't understand the buyer's journey, what drives buyer? Most of the time it end up into a website which looks sexy, but it's a dumb shape. Doesn't work for you, right? It's just most of the time we end up making our client happy. And the client decide everything and you just have to build and you said, okay, fine. You want blue, I'll make blue. You want little red, I'll make it red. And that's how the website end up into a pile of shit. It doesn't work for you, okay? So if the buyer's journey, if you really want to know, in a 30 minute session, I can't teach you buyer's journey. I've entered a blog on the buyer's journey. I'm going to show you snippets of this, but if you want to read more, come and read my blog. Everything if you do correctly, you don't need a salesman. digital fellow will never have a salesman ever. Till the time people exist, we'll never have a salesman. We always get business out of content. These are something important stages. The first one, no one understands. Most people get understanding to awareness stage, even if they understand inbound marketing, they make content on consideration stage, decision stage and blah blah blah. Not much people do the first stage, where is no need zone, where you make content for people who are, they don't know whether to buy this product or not. So that's a holy grail. The moment you hit that place, the no need zone space, you will get a lot of customers who never thought can be your business prospect. It also comes from buyer persona. I'm going to tell you the anatomy of a content. How do anatomy, the structure of a content look like? The architecture of a content look like? Before that, anyone heard of Simon Sinek? Here, raise hands. Okay, great. Have you heard the Simon Sinek's one principle where he spoke on the golden rule? Why, what, how? If any of you have not heard, because I see majority have not heard, please see the video where he explained. There are different rules. One of the rules which I follow, or I make my work, most of my clients whom I work with, where we use this, we follow this golden circle. Why, how, what. Sometimes you can go inside out and sometimes you can go outside in, based on the two different type of business you manage. So this is how it looks like. If it is a developing brand or it's an established brand, the two approach, you can go from inside to outside, what, how and why. So why, how, what is up. So I'll let me explain what is what and what you mean by what. First, people want to know, what is it for me? They really don't care who you are. They don't really care about this product. They want to ask, what is the problem you want to solve for me? Tell me first. One, then it gives you a patient here. Second, how you are going to solve it? Show me that. Third, why will I believe you? These are three cognitive questions, people. This is not, it's also pure science. We have three different parts of the lobes, brain, and that's how a brain decodes a conversation or a logic. These apply to human being. So if your logic in this manner, you will definitely win the client. What is the problem I want to solve? I'm going to show you how I want to solve. And these are the 20 reasons, the 5 reasons, the 3 reasons that you should believe me. This is how the content structure is meant. Most of the content writers don't even know this. Two brands, two different approach. Simon spoke about two things. How Apple do a invite out or outward in approach. How they use, they never spoke on a feature. Never. Apple product hardly talk about features. They talk about no innovations. Right? So see the video, it's a 7-8 minute video, small video. It will change your life and the way I follow the website, the content journey, the strategy. My entire thing is based on golden rule. Only these three principles. What I teach, I actually practice. You can go and check it on my website. Distributing content is another difficult task. Most people don't do that. I see, you know what they do? One content, cut, paste in 5 things, same, publish. That's not you should publish. That's not the way you do content marketing, or that's not the way you spread your content, right? So content marketing has three things, which is called tofu, mofu, bofu. Top of the funnel, middle of the funnel, bottom of the funnel. These are same thing. Awareness stage. You want to aware of the brand. Middle of the stage, where you want to consider should I take the brand out of 3-4 brands. The last stage, when you buy the product of the brand, when you decide to buy. These are funnel. So if you ask any content writer, okay, whatever content or blog, whatever you wrote, this is my sales funnel. Can you plot which blog or which content goes to each of my funnel? They will say, that's not my job. Most people don't understand this. Also, there's a math to it. There's a number to it. When I was in Coke, I launched Coke 20 years back, 22 years back. I launched Coke, so at that time when I launched, there are a lot of sampling is to do. It says that if you 8 to 9 times, if you start drinking Coke, your tongue or your palate gets used to Coke. You're not able to take Pepsi. Okay? And you should do a lot of cigarette also. If you smoke one brand for 20 times, it gets hooked to your liver. You're not able to change any other brand. Same thing happens when you do a content. So the process is top of the funnel, awareness content should be 70%. 20% is middle of the funnel, and the 10% is bottom of the funnel. Please take this number seriously. If you try to do any fudging in terms of number, 20% I will do, 10% will do. Okay, my boss is saying you should sell more, 70% I will sell. You know what happens when you sell 70% of your content? Sell, 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 buy me. It's like that, I meet you the first time and I'm looking at your purse or your pocket, will you like me? Answer is no. The same thing you're doing when you make content, you're trying to sell. Who cares who you're selling? So what happened? End of the day, price become a parameter. Your price versus other price. Every six to seven months I increase my fees. Yeah. Every 6 months I increase my fees. How can I do that? I started with one chair and one table in a small startup office environment. Now we are 22 people. Possible. If I can do, you can also do that. By the way, you also think, who are your clients? If I tell you one, you will get hundreds. I consult one. World Bank will never come to a small startup like me, which means I give them so much of value. By the way, I didn't approach to World Bank. They found me on my LinkedIn content. Most of my business comes from LinkedIn and Twitter and Facebook. I don't do Google AdWords. Zero. Z-E-R-O. No Google AdWords. No SEO. On-page SEO I do. To make Google Spider discover my content. That's good. But paying Google and looking for AdWords and paying traffic? No, I don't do that. There's something called waterfall theory. I don't know whether you know this. There's something called hub, hero, and hygiene. What are these? It looks like this. There should be some hero content. There should be some hub content. And there should be some hygienic content. Each content perform in different manner. Okay, let me simplify, you know. What you take in the breakfast, you have it in dinner? Answer is no. So human beings eat different type of food at different, they're all food, but they're not consuming same time. Same thing happens with the human brain. Same type of content is a content, but the type of content varies. So the hero content are generally big content. I give you an example right now, you see, these people are shooting. They're actually making a hero content. I'm going to talk for 20 minutes or 30 minutes, then we have a Q&A session and some people will be outside talking to me. They're going to record the entire content and make a big content, which is Shubho spoke on content marketing strategy of Taj. This goes on YouTube. Now my content team is going to cut it and chop up the most important part and make small series on a YouTube, on a Facebook, or maybe on a Twitter, maybe on a all 1 minute, 2 minute, 3 minute small video. That's how you create a hero content and hub content and small content where micro and macro content, that's how you do it. So what I'm telling you, I practice, you can see that. And next 2 weeks time, you'll see this video up on YouTube and you'll see the small portion coming up as a teaser in different other channels. By the way, how much of content, I don't know, how much of content you guys produce. As I speak today, right now, if you go to any of my channel, I am around in what? 54, yesterday night, I think you gave me a feedback. Around 54 channels are there, different, in groups also. In LinkedIn and 15-20 groups we follow. So all my content, every day I publish 120 content, every single day. On this grammatical process which I just said, hero, hub, and 120 content. You know why I win and I don't need a salesman? Because most of the salesmen whom you hire are a BD, business development, I don't have a single one. These guys take leads, they go back 10 to 6. You know how, what's the lifespan of a blog? How much a blog can give you? A great blog which is 1900 words, correctly structured, will give you return for 3 years. That's the lifespan of a blog. And this 3 years blog, he doesn't take a leave, he doesn't take a chutti, he doesn't go home at 6 o'clock. He's working for me 24/7 for the 3 years. One blog get me a business of 35 to 50 lakhs. One single blog get me a business. Do I need a salesman? I don't think so. I never need a salesman. So this is how the power of portrait. So this is what I'm talking you. I'm talking right now. So what the most important line I picked up is a great quote, which I believe: content build relationships. Relationships are built on trust. Trust drives revenue. Most of the conferences where I go, I see people come and they pitch. It's a sales pitch. So commercial it has happened. People come and say, these are my software, these are my case study, this is what I do, come and buy. They come out on the stage and they exchange card. In case I give any of my card or my visiting card, in my visiting card, a few friends are sitting here, they know. He's raising his hand. I don't have a single number, a phone number, a Twitter handle, nothing. My card has nothing. Just the logo and the name, nothing. You know why? Because Google's 5.45 seconds. 0.45 seconds. 0.45 seconds, right? You can try it on your phone. The network is bad right now, you still use 5. So how can I do that? This is things I do right. If you do this thing right, you will never need a salesman or BD to run and pitch, right? You will get sorted, people will find you. You can also go reverse waterfall theory, which I also follow. How? Imagine you are making slideshows. Lots of stories on slideshows, imagine. Pick up the best 20 slideshows, convert that into an ebook, and that becomes a pillar content. You can actually make small content, stitch it up and make a large content. So you can actually use a large reverse flow. This is how the content validity check look like. I'm going to show you this. It takes nearly 6 to 12 months, right, to get attraction. Most of us are so impatient. The client is impatient, the agency is obviously impatient. They want result. I have paid you right now, and where is my lead? It doesn't work like that, because most agencies don't have this answer. They think, okay, sir, definitely give me 1 week time, I'll get you 5 leads. The moment you give 5 leads, out of that 4 leads didn't work for me. So you are not doing your SEO correctly. Sir, let us make blog. I don't need blog, I need lead. So the problem is that we don't teach the client. We don't educate the client. And most of the client, marketing heads or the CMO, is a 45-year-old guy who comes from a traditional business, has no idea, must have forgotten his Twitter handle and password, don't do anything on digital, but demands job for it. If you teach this process, the moment you do a 6-month traction, you don't need anything. So amount of money they spend, 2 lakh, 3 lakh, you do the SEO, you don't need that. Spend that amount of money into blog and content and different type of content and video. So that video, that content is going to help you for the next 3 years time. 3 years, one blog, that's the power. So these are shots I think you should understand before making. Distribution also. How do you distribute? And what happened? You distribute and you don't analyze. So every month you should analyze. There's nothing called right and wrong on digital. Digital is all about what user like. So most of us don't do analysis. And you know what? Who do analysis? The marketing head who doesn't understand anything. He will say, no, I didn't like your meme. I didn't like this blog. I didn't like this image. And agency has no other option. Okay, sir, I'll change it tomorrow. That's how it was happening. If you educate your content, one of my agency friends told me, how do I teach the client? So my question or my answer to that guy is that, how many blogs do you have to teach? He didn't have a single blog. If you don't teach, the client is going to make you fool, or going to ask you stupid questions, and it's going to be round and round. It will never get out of this, matrix. Analysis is what I do every month. When I say analysis, I will not need to show you, my time is over, but still, analysis is a very deep dive analysis. When I do analysis, it's like, Facebook, we have a total, I think, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, Snapchat, TikTok. How many of you have a TikTok videos? Corporate guy have a corporate video, or an agency have a, not personal video. How many guys have a video on TikTok? Raise hands. Afraid? No. Try seeing my TikTok. 170 videos I have. Not me having some fun educating people on TikTok. So all of you are thinking it's too late. TikTok is one of the best channels. The best performing channel in terms of algorithm, it is helping you to reach faster. If you don't pay anything, Facebook will never make you rich. So you will not able to reach that far. It is purposely done so that you cannot reach. If you pay Facebook, then it will algorithm will make you discovered. Unlike LinkedIn and TikTok, there are two channels which is free. You can actually get a lot of traction if you are a startup or a marketing app or making content. The last, yeah. Yes. Content is a damn costly, damn complex, very difficult, difficult model. You know how the model look like? If you search how to write content, Google will give you 1,53 million pages on content. You'll get confused. If you read, I'm a hardcore reader of Neil Patel, with all respect. If you go to Neil Patel, ask, Neil Patel will give you 20,000 videos about how to do SEO. If you go to Google, Google will give you, pay me SEO, pay me something, I'll make your product. If you go to Facebook, pay me first, I will, you know, do my boosting and XYZ. Everybody is looking at your pocket. No one is telling you a simple way how the content marketing works. So I thought, why don't I make one? So this is for all of you. This is the blueprint of content strategy. You can take a picture. You can go to my blog. There's a very deep down approach of part by part where I've mentioned what is a no-need stage, what to do there. What is awareness stage? What exactly to write content? What is a buyer persona? How to write a buyer persona? Then how to make a pillar content? How to break the pillar content to micro content? How you can do a reverse journey? How to make a tofu? What is a tofu content should look like? Everything I've mentioned, you need to read. I read and I could do this. I'm sure all of you can do this. And how to distribute a hub and a spoke content and agile content. That's it. Thank you so much. Now.